chance, it's your save. That's a magnificent hit.
Welcome to the sixth edition of Brighton Lights. My name is Val Aviv. Brighton, home to 200,000 people, but a million dreams. I'm here in the JAG Gallery here on Brighton Seafront to meet with the celebrity painter, Julie-Anne Gilburt. Hi, Julie.
Hello.
How's it going?
I'm fine. You look gorgeous.
Thank you, sweetie.
Not very often we get such gorgeous girls.
I bet that's just not true because you're here just about every day. So tell me, you've been doing some celebrity painters. Who have you painted?
I've painted, portrait-wise, I've painted Mike Tyson, Michelle Gale, Michael Watson.
And who have you painted with?
Phil Tufnell's my favourite. He's funny. And he comes down to paint. And Katie Price, she's funny too, actually.
Is she a good painter?
She is. She really focuses when she's painting.
She's in the zone.
Absolutely in the zone, yeah.
Totally amazing. And what's this pile here then?
Well, who have we got here? Mushroom Risotto by Jamie Oliver. See?
He's a talented man, not just a good cook.
That's good, isn't it? And who's that one? I haven't checked these out, actually, yet. Jude Law. There you go. Is that a tree or is that...
It could be a volcano.
Volcano?
With hearts and stars.
Or broccoli. I think we should put some pink sparkly bits on there, yeah. And who's that? Four Puffs and a Piano?
Let me guess. That's got to be Jonathan Ross.
It's good, isn't it?
Fantastic. So what else have you been doing this week? Do tell us. I hear you've been out on the town.
Well, thanks to you guys, because you were too busy, I got sent out in town, and I don't get out much, so it's quite fun, really. And, we saw lots of sexy ladies doing the Miss
sexy
World
ladies?
Thing. Yeah, no, was it Miss World? Miss Brighton.
Miss Brighton.
Yeah, Miss Brighton thing. That was
Miss
fun.
Brighton today, yes. Miss World tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly. And we got them to strip off. Not that we can use that footage.
Well, I think we should take a look and check it out.
Latest TV Rock!
Beautiful legs, and I made them kneel on the pebbles for a shoot. I hope that goes by tonight.
Yeah.
Okay, that little speech thing that you do, you know, if you win, and it's all about, you know, saving the world.
Well, I would use my powers.
I like the accent. That's good. She's going to use her powers.
Use my powers for the greater good of the world and help all the little children, help them make sure they've got a bed to sleep in and food to eat every night. That's
good.
What I love.
I like the accent. That's cute.
I don't know about saving the world. I'd like to obviously save myself a little bit here. I'd like to make myself rich and famous. Obviously, go out nice swanky bars. Have a nice house, 2.5 children, a good looking husband.
And save up for boob job.
Yeah, exactly. It made me very happy.
I've always wanted to do that walk. You know that walk that they do? It's great, isn't it? Imagine walking like that every day. There's lots of pretty ladies walking around, and you turn around, there's an old boy with her. And that's just Bill. Very exciting.
Are you entering?
No, a bit old for that.
You were saying I should enter.
Yeah, I think so.
You were saying you think you could make me win.
Bikini.
How would you do it?
Bikini, that's all you need, Bill.
A bikini?
Yeah.
How am I going to get a bikini?
Trust me, I'm an artist.
But I thought maybe I could compete. How do you think I've done?
I think you'll be spectacular. Absolutely spectacular. You have a killer body.
So what's this all about then?
This is the gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous Carol.
We've got a gorgeous Miss Brighton, and we hope that she's going to win Miss UK.
As you know, we've been here tonight for the bright heat of Miss World, and here I have with me the winner.
I would have given you my spot for that.
Oh my God, thank
you. You again, I love you. She's so funny. I love her.
This is the best bit.
You won't be marrying a footballer, I tell
you. Oh no, I will spend my own money.
Oh, thank you.
that phenomenal woman in the words of the great Maya Angelou.
I used to drive buses once, badly. Brighton is Music City. It's home to bands such as The Beautiful Word. We sent Elena Saorin to check out The Beautiful Word's EP launch. Julie-Anne, can you think of a beautiful word?
Val, I think I love you.
I think that's more than one word.
We're here at the latest music bar where The Beautiful Word are launching their new EP, Mystery Pop. Let's go and check it out.
The Beautiful Word presents Mystery Pop!
Hello, Beautiful Word. So, tell me your names.
Emily.
Megan.
Scotty.
And Nelson.
And then that's Graf. Graf Wave.
That's all our lovely faces. It's going to be a samurai, a tiger, a lady. I'm a Venetian princess. And Nelson is a gangster. Yeah, we're a mature band. I enrolled on this songwriting course at college, and Emily was on it, and she'd already been writing for a while.
Yeah, I was never taught guitar, so I kind of just built my songs around what I could figure out. More recently, it's been sort of a collaboration.
Nelson might add something, it might change the song completely. My style, '70s kind of vibe.
The song I wrote doesn't actually have any lyrics, it's more of an instrumental track. I'm quite honoured it got on the CD, really.
What is mystery pop?
Yeah, we're mystery pop, it's the genre we invented.
We wanted it to be like pop music and to be accessible and to be memorable and catchy and lovely, but we wanted it to have elements of sort of mystery and curiosity.
What would you expect from tonight?
If you're in fancy dress and you want to enter yourself, dance around here during this song.
Fun.
And I'll do my best to judge from that.
Stardom.
It's going to be such a good vibe.
I think people should be excited about life, so we try and make life exciting.
Mystery Pop is now open for buying.
Can someone put an ice cream on my face?
Okay, we're here on Brighton Seafront. This is actually the starting point for the Pride Parade. This is where it's all going to kick off. But this year, there's been a lot of controversy about whether or not it will even start. So we sent Bill Smith to meet with James Ledward to get the inside story and the exclusive. Check it out.
Has Pride lost the support of the key members of the Brighton gay scene? Because that surely is a disaster.
Well, it's difficult to answer that question. If I speak honestly, I say I do believe they have.
James goes on to say candidly what has gone wrong with Pride this year, and most importantly, how it should be put right, how Brighton and Hove Council can resolve all disputes, and why politics and an arts festival need to be part of Pride, not just indulgence. If you care about Pride, for this whole exclusive interview, click here now.
That's all for this week. See you all next time. We're going to leave you with The Beautiful Word. I think I love you.